It's showtime for MLB The Show 21 Diamond Dynasty. So one of the first things that I want to just say, it appears by what we got today in today's feature premiere that the dark theme that we have seen in the March to October feature premiere and in other aspects of the game is making its way across all game modes. And I enjoy this kind of, you know, dark theme. Things kind of stand out. It's a change, you know. They haven't really messed with the user interface, is, you know, for several years running. It's kind of just been the same thing. So it's nice to see, you know, as we go into the next gen, as we go into next gen systems and everything, for the look to change. I think that it's a, you know, it's a subtle move, but it's nice to have some variety. So just quickly, as we're on the screen, guys, this video didn't really provide us with a whole lot of new information for any consistent MLB The Show players. This feature premiere was more for new players, more for Xbox users, I want to say, for people that are just now starting out in Diamond Dynasty for the first time ever. And I just want to kind of do a preview of this screen for you all. So this is your Diamond Dynasty squad page is what this is. And as you can see, Eloy Jimenez is your best player on your team right now. He's an 80 overall. If you look at his card art, he is a 80 overall. He is a gold. You have different tiers in Diamond Dynasty. The best cards that you can get are diamond. Next best would be gold, then silver, then bronze, and then there's common players as well. We have no diamonds on this team at all. It's very difficult to get diamonds in the game. Well, I shouldn't say it's difficult. You just don't get diamonds in the game really to start out. And so this is obviously a team that's constructed pretty early on in the game's, you know, cycle. This would be a team that you would probably open the game up with to start out in Diamond Dynasty. Quickly, you can see here that you can play against others online and or offline against the computer to stack your team and earn these cards in the game. For those that are new also, the whole point of Diamond Dynasty is to build the best team possible. And you may be thinking that it's only possible with current MLB players. That's not the case. Diamond Dynasty also has cards from they have flashback cards, Player of the Month cards, Prime Series cards. These are cards of players that have been retired for several years. You might get a David Ortiz, you might get a Pedro Martinez, you might get a Cal Ripken Jr., a Reggie Jackson, a Willie Mays. You know, these players have been retired from the game for several years on end. But Diamond Dynasty is all about building the best possible team that you can. So current MLB players, you're not limited to just them. You can also earn yourself, you know, flashback series, prime series, so on and so forth, you know, players that have been since gone from the game for several years. So this right here is what they call the XP reward path. If you look, just going on here, at 5,000 XP, and again, guys, you XP is experience. You earn XP by just playing the game. Doesn't matter what you're doing. Franchise mode, Road to the Show, Diamond Dynasty, as long as you are just logging into the game and playing the game, you are earning XP in some manner. So at 5,000 XP, you are getting some stubs here. At 10,000 XP, you're getting a Show 21 pack. At 17,500 XP, you're getting Petco Park. At 25,000 XP, you're getting some stubs again. 32,500 XP, you're getting 10 The Show packs, so on and so forth. So there is an XP reward path that you move forward and progress through the game, you know, just by playing. Also, you see that this is the first inning program in the game. I'm not much of a Diamond Dynasty player, but I do know this. There are different programs as the year continues on. The first inning program is going to be the first program that Diamond Dynasty gets to start out the release of the game. I want to say probably about a month later or a little over a month later, you're going to move on to the second inning program. third inning, fourth inning, fifth inning, so on and so forth. And every program that is entered, you have a new XP reward path that you're grinding through. So this little diagram will just be replicated by new programs, if that makes any sense. One thing that I do know really well, the player attributes. I do know those very well. Now, player attributes can change. They're not always the same. This is Harrison Bader over in Diamond Dynasty. What we like to call his live series card, or his card that would be used in franchise mode or road to the show mode, might be a little bit different than this card. His attributes may not be the exact same. Also, attributes can change based on performance. I know in franchise mode, because that's the mode I play most often, I spend the most time on. Harrison Bader, his fielding may go up or his fielding may go down based on how you perform with him on the field. Let's say for a 10-game stretch, he has two errors or something like that. His fielding may get a hit. He may not be a 95 anymore. He may go down to a 93 or a 92. So, attributes can change, as well as this card where he's a 78 overall. He may not be a 78 overall in franchise mode. Likelihood is he's probably around that. It's probably not much different, but he may not be an exact 78. So just understand that the Diamond Dynasty overall, the attributes, the rankings and all that, and the overall ratings can differ from other game modes in MLB The Show 21. So, looking over at the attributes, we have a 78 overall Harrison Bader. His fielding's at 95. His arm is at 75. Arm is going to be, that's going to be arm strength as well as arm accuracy. There's two different attributes there. You have a player's arm strength and power. Then you also have their accuracy to throw the ball on target. Reaction is reaction time when the ball is hit and put into play. How quick does that player get to that ball, or how quick does that player react to make a move towards catching that? In Bader's case, he's playing center field, so how fast does Bader react to a fly ball or a line drive? Now, reaction is also a very, very important attribute, because that impacts this kind of animations that a player gets in the game. So let's say we're using, let's just turn our attention to Franmil Reyes. I'm sure that Franmil does not have a reaction of 96. He's going to get a lot of different animations as opposed to a Harrison Bader. Harrison Bader is faster. He'll get probably a better animation. He can probably climb the wall. He's a lot more nimble and agile than a Franmil Reyes is. He's going to get better movement in the game and better animations, and he's probably going to catch a lot more line drive type hits rather than a Franmil Reyes. He's going to get to a lot of other balls in play rather than a Franmil Reyes. Franmil will get there, don't get me wrong, it's just going to take him longer. Speed also, Bader's at 95, that's pretty self-explanatory. Speed and stealing are blue because that is in relation to him on the base paths. Speed also relates to him also out in the field and fielding, but reaction is kind of the equivalent of speed on the base paths. Reaction really depends on how fast he is in the field, if that makes any sense. Speed is a player's quickness on the base paths if he's to get on base. So he's at a 95, and stealing is at a 44. That's if you're to take off stealing with him. There's also, I don't know if it'll be an MLB The Show 21, but it has been an MLB The Show 20. Base runner aggressiveness is also a thing. That's just, how aggressive they are on the base paths. Just, how many stolen base attempts do they have in a season? I'm sure that's how they kind of calculate that attribute. And the rest is all red. That's all of his batting attributes. That's arguably the most important. That takes up half of his attribute circle, if you will, or player card. That is the most important when you are trying to assess a player, is their batting. Against righties, Harrison Bader has a contact of 46 and a power of 50. Against lefties, he has a contact of 60 and a power of 64. So Bader is better against left-handed pitching than he is against right-handed pitching. And you're going to find that to be commonplace because Bader is a right-handed batter, and most batters are worse against pitchers of the same handedness. If you know baseball, you know that. Vision 49, that is the plate coverage indicator that you see while you're playing a game. That affects how big or small that plate coverage indicator will be while you are playing the game, and that will assist in hopefully you getting a base hit or not getting a base hit or striking out or hopefully putting a ball in play and utilizing that 95 speed that Bader has. He'll probably beat out a few ground balls. Just quickly, I want to talk about the MLB The Show 21 tech test. I'm not going to get into too much detail. I have jumped into the tech test myself, and that's about to the extent that I am going to go on that. I have agreed to not share anything as far as, you know, on social media or anything of the matter regarding the tech test. All I will say is that if you have received an invite for the tech test, check your PlayStation notifications. It will be in there. Xbox is a little bit different, so I will share links down in the description of this video to how to reach the invite if you got one. I will include the forum that they want you to provide feedback on, that MLB The Show and Sony San Diego Studios wants you to provide feedback on if you did, in fact, receive an invite and you've played the tech test any. So I'll include that forum down below. And then if you just have questions, or if you're looking for a group to kind of get involved with around the game, I would suggest that you join the MLB The Show 21 closed Facebook group that I'm a part of. It's a private group. You're going to have to be accepted by administrators of the group, but it's a very resourceful tool. Some things, of course, on there aren't as helpful as others, but it's a good place to go for, you know, just conversation around the game as well as information within the community. I highly, highly recommend it for all of you new players, specifically Xbox players that this may be the first time of you ever stepping into the community. So I would highly recommend, I will leave the link for that Facebook group down in the description of this video as well. And that's going to do it for this video, guys. If you all enjoyed it, leave a like on this video. Comment any questions that you have down below. I will try to answer them to the best of my ability. As I've mentioned before, I'm not much of a Diamond Dynasty player. But if I don't know the answer, I can probably direct you to somebody that does know the answer, just from being in the community. And then, as well, subscribe to the channel, turn post notifications on so you all are always updated on the latest MLB The Show 21 news. I'll be covering these feature premieres leading all the way up to release, and of course, playing the game once it is out in April. So until the next video, guys, Tabor time out. Peace.